Hello friends, in this video we will discuss about the virtual machines, and in this video we will cover what is virtualization, what is virtual machine and how it works, what is hypervisor, and finally we will cover how to create a virtual machine. I will show a demo by creating a virtual machine also. So let's start from virtualization. So before we understand virtualization, first we understand what is the meaning of virtual. Anything which is not real is known as virtual. The same thing we have used in computing. So virtualization can be defined as a technology or the process by which we create a virtual version of something. And that something can be a hardware, it can be a storage device, it can be a computer network resource, or it can be a complete computer machine. As shown in the diagram, when we don't using the virtualization, there is a single PC. It is using its hardware independently. It has a single operating system and applications. But after virtualization, the same hardware is shared by two virtual machines. So what is the virtual machine? A virtual machine is a software program that creates an image, or we can say copy, of a computer system that exists only in the software form. In this form, it uses the physical resources of the physical computer system what behave like a separate actual computer. So in simple words, we can say a virtual machine is a software computer. Virtual machine, generally known as guest, and the physical computer on which a virtual machine is created is known as host. A virtual machine does not have its own hardware. It uses resources of the host computer, and multiple virtual machines can exist within a single host at any one time. Now we see how a virtual machine works. So in diagram you seeing a physical system which has CPU, memory, disk and network card. It contains a single operating system and applications. This is before the virtualization. Now what the virtualization done? This second diagram shows a system with virtualization software. Here the CPU, memory, disk and network resources are same. What we have used a virtualization software which creates two virtual machines by sharing the resources of the physical system. So the physical system is known as host, and the virtual machine that are created are known as the guest. This virtualization software is known as the hypervisor. Virtual machines can be implemented by two methods. One is the software emulation methods. Second is the hardware virtualization techniques. So depending on the use and the level of the correspondence or to any physical computer, virtual machine can be divided into two categories. One is the system virtual machine and second is the process virtual machine. System virtual machines provides a system platform that support the sharing of the host computer physical resources like hard disk, RAM, network cards between multiple virtual machines, and each virtual machine has its own copy of the operating system. The second type is the process virtual machine. In this system, it will provide a platform independent programming environment. So basically, it masks the information of the hardware or the operating system and allows the program execution to take place in the same way on any given platform. A virtual machine offers several advantages. Multiple operating systems can be provided on a single physical computer. They are very easy to manage and maintain, offer application provisioning, disaster recovery option, and the most important advantage, it is very cost effective. But virtual machine has some drawbacks also. Virtual machines are not as efficient as a physical computer because hardware resources are the shared resources. And if a single host or physical machine is running multiple virtual machines, then performance may be unstable sometimes. So next, let's see what is hypervisor. As we have seen in previous pictures, a computer software, firmware or hardware that can create or run virtual machine is known as the hypervisor. It is also shown in the diagram. It is also known as virtual machine monitor. A computer on which a hypervisor run one or more virtual machine is known as host machine. and each virtual machine is called as guest machine. We have already discussed this. So there are some examples of the hypervisor softwares. These are the software programs provided by different firms: VMware, Oracle VirtualBox, Oracle VirtualBox, Oracle BM for x86, Solaris Jones, Parallels, and VMware Workstations. So the next, how to create a virtual machine? What we need: a host means a computer system. It may be a PC, laptop, or a server. Second, a program that can create the virtual machine means hypervisor. And third, the operating system image for that virtual machine. So for the demo, I have chosen a laptop with Windows 10 operating system, in Oracle VirtualBox as hypervisor, and Linux Debian version 9 for operating system. So let's start. This is my laptop with Windows 10 operating system, and next two things that we have to install: one is the Oracle VirtualBox and second Debian operating system on that virtual machine. Debian and VirtualBox you can download from internet. These softwares are available of free of cost. So start the installation of VirtualBox. Next, here you will get some options regarding the setup. Select options that you require: VirtualBox USB support, VirtualBox networking if you want networking connections. Next, do next again. Here it is showing some warning regarding the network interface. Please proceed with the installation. Yes, and click on install. It may take some time, so I will cut that waiting period and will show you when I get the final installation display. So during installation, it will ask for some permissions. Please give them these permissions to the software: install and Oracle BM VirtualBox is installed. Click on finish. Okay, now the next step is the configuration of the VirtualBox. So open the Oracle BM VirtualBox. In first step, we have to add the optical disk. In this optical disk, we will point to the ISO image of the operating system. So we have already downloaded the Debian operating system E drive software virtual machine. I will select Debian 9.5 and open. So a virtual optical disk is created. Now I will add a virtual machine. So click on the machine and select the option new. Here I will give test 1. In operating type, we will select Linux, version Debian 64, and click on the next. Next option, select the RAM size. In next window, it will ask for the hard disk. A virtual hard disk needs to be created. The default recommended size of hard disk is 8 GB. Keep it default 8 GB. Click create. Hard disk file type, also keep it at default. Again, next option is storage on physical hard disk. It is dynamically allocated default and created. So a virtual machine is created, and now we have to install the operating system on this virtual machine. So select the machine and click on the start button. So Linux setup is now started on your virtual machine. You can use up and down arrow to select the options. So I will select graphical install, press enter. So here you can select language, continue, select your country. I am from India, selected India, and continue. American English, continue. Now it is installation has been started. This installation takes nearly 1.5 hours. Give the host name Linux 1, continue. Your domain name, if you are on a network with domain name, you can type here, else leave it blank. Continue. Root password, so type your root password here. Full name for the new user, username for your account, password for the new user. So in this screen, it will ask for the partition disk. So select the first one, guided use entire disk. You can choose other options also as per your requirement. Continue, select all default options and press continue. So in this screen it is asking for the partition disk. Select yes and press continue. Now in the next screen it will ask to configure the package manager. So if you want to scan another CD DVD, press yes, else press no. So I don't want to scan, so I select no and press continue. Again select default options. Installation in progress. As it takes more than 1 hour, so I will cut the waiting period video and will show you the key screen after installation. So the next window comes. It is regarding the configuration of popularity contest. Keep the default options and press continue. So the next screen shows software selection. I will select Debian desktop, Wave server, SSH server or standard system utilities. Press continue. So after 1 hour the setup is already completed. Now after completion it will ask for installing the bootloader program. So select yes and press continue. So friends, installation is complete. Now press continue and our system is rebooting. So now system is started. We will log in now. Give password. And your Linux based virtual machine is ready to operate now. So friends, in this way we can create virtual machines in a physical laptop or PC. So we will try to open browser and try to surf any website here. So browser is open. I will try to open website itjunction.org. So friends, it is clear now. The virtual machine is working perfectly. Network connection is okay. So friends, in this video we have learned what is virtualization, what is virtual machine and how we can create a virtual machine on a physical computer. Thanks for watching the video. If you like my video, then please like and subscribe my channel. Leave your comments also. Thanks.